derrière, que tout le monde est dans le bouton.
Oh, yeah?
Hey, everybody, here. 1, 2, 3.
Charlie, 2. Win.
Big break,
two.
Oh!
Bank it up. Set it up
for yourself. Really,
really. Yes, beautiful.
That'd be me. We're all right.
Clean it up. Hey, brother. $5?
Hey, piss off, you drunken rummy. Get out of here.
Hey, come here. Look at me. Come on, look at me.
Hell, how about this?
I'll give you a nice, shiny new quarter if you look at me, huh? Look me in the eye. Come on, look me in the eye. Come on, look at me.
Most godless bunch of people I've ever seen in my life. Oh, you look in the eye!
Oh, beautiful. All right.
Don't give him a good leave, Charlie. Concentrate. You do this. Okay.
Hey, brother.
Get off me.
Hey. I'm sorry, brother.
I ain't your brother.
Hey, come on, you out of here.
Here, you got enough now, okay?
Let's go.
Come on, take a shot. Yeah. Raining rummies here. Woo!
Wait, stop.
Why?
Stop, Charlie, stop. I have your birthday present. I have your birthday present.
My birthday's not till tomorrow.
Come on, open your present.
I'm opening my present.
It's 7.
Yeah, so?
Wait, it's 7, and Shep said you're supposed to be there at 6:30. It's 7.
Oh, okay. You know what? Hold on.
I'll be right back. Give me 5 minutes.
All right.
We tried calling, but... Oh. Sorry.
Aren't you really just gonna eat? What about your present?
What?
Your present?
Yeah, right. I'll tell you what. As soon as I get back, I'll open it, okay? I promise. All right, I'm gonna call you. I'll be back before you know it. So you just help yourself to anything you need in the fridge. And, see ya.
Here you go, fellas. Queen Maud Gulf. We'll set up your first camp right by the ocean.
go that far?
Cover the territories, every bloody inch.
Morning, fellas. Miss anything?
Wow. It's a beaut. What is it? Cessna?
She's a Norseman.
Right. So you got the pontoons on? Floats. Right.
Would you excuse us a second? Hey, Charlie.
Yeah.
Knock it off.
What?
You know what? Now knock it off.
Come on, these guys are a couple of cupcakes here. I'm just trying to have fun.
Now look, this is a really big contract. You piss those guys off, they're gonna take their business someplace else.
Oh, bullshit. They ain't going nowhere.
Oh, yeah? Well, you just make sure that they don't.
Speaking of which, how about a little detour after my run?
Where?
Bathurst.
Oh, yeah.
Why?
Business.
Oh, yeah.
What kind of business?
Oh, a little business, business. Come on, 2 or 3 days, I'm in, I'm out. Make it worth your while.
Two.
Three.
Two. And you let me know where you are.
All right.
And try to keep those guys happy, will you?
Hey, get your suit all dirty.
Oh,
it's kind of grimy up here.
Oh, yeah, thanks.
So, you've been flying long?
I guess the better part of 12 years.
He's my best pilot. Flew in the war.
Huh. Africa? No, Europe. Flew Boston's and mosquitoes mostly. Yeah, bombed the hell out of Mannheim and Bremen. Hell, I would have sunk the Bismarck if they gave me half a chance.
I was infantry myself.
Well, sir, you have my sympathies. So you have a co-pilot you work with?
Sure do. Like the book says, God.
Heavy little buggers, huh? You didn't expect to see anybody here. You fellas like chocolate?
eat the stuff? Thanks again. Get anime.
Come.
Huh?
Come.
What do you got there?
Please, come.
You got some pelts? Little white fox? What, wanna do a little trading? Yeah, sure, what the hell. Is she your girlfriend or your sister?
Well,
she's sick. I can't do anything for her. And she's got TB or something. You know, tuberculosis?
You, Yellowknife.
Huh? No, I'm not even going straight back. I can't take her. You take her back to her village. You got a medicine man or something, don't you? I mean, the hospitals in Yellowknife are full. Huh? She stay.
Sorry, I don't know.
What do you got there?
Holy smokes.
A lot of money right there.
Yellowknife.
All right, shit. I'm deadheading anyway. But you hurry, all right? I got a storm brewing. So, Yavavi.
Tovi, is that your nakto?
Oh, Dakamang.
Ano yang ititin? Ano yang ititin? Oh,
Dakamang nama.
Kapiling it.
Give me your government number there. Eskimo tag in case I get a hold of you. E51254. All right. This her stuff? Okay. Wabi! Come on. Okay, here. Up. There you go.
Kapiso, come on.
Yellowknife!
Yeah, Yellowknife. I said I'd take her to Yellowknife. Just come visit her in the spring. Bring her a potted plant. Bad days, I guess, huh? Coffee?
What the hell with it? But he said we screw Bathurst, head straight for home. Get around this miserable weather. Funny thing is, I was just going there to sell off those crates of soda, maybe scrounge up some ivory, and kinda got that covered. Life is funny that way.
Well, you might as well get out. She's broken. She smashed the hell, you understand? Don't fly no more.
fishing. The hell kind of fish are you gonna catch in here?
This is Juliet, India, November. Does anyone read? Does anyone read? Warren, do you copy? Bathurst, Baker Lake, anyone?
No. Hey, hey, easy, easy with that. No, no. Get out of here with that. I'm trying to... Oh, you know what? No, just go, go. You eat it if you're gonna eat it like that. Go. You speak any English? You speak any English? Yes, no, a little bit? No? Well, I don't know if you understand our situation here, but we're in a hell of a bind. See, nobody knows where the hell we are. The reason being is I didn't stick to my flight plan. My radio's busted. I can't call out. Try and fix it in the morning, but I think my tools are on the bottom of that lake somewhere. So I'm just saying, there's a good chance nobody's gonna show up. Okay. Good talking to you.
Hey, Chef. Still no sign of him. I'm starting to think.
No sign of who? Charlie?
Yeah. He just got a little delayed by the weather, that's all. Now, why would you want to go say something like that in front of her for, huh?
I didn't know she was standing right here.
Jesus, Carl. You know Charlie's got women stashed all over the bloody map.
I know, but still, shouldn't we have heard something by now?
Hey, don't worry about it. He's fine. I start worrying about Charlie Halliday 5 minutes after hell freezes over. I'll tell you what, though. He better be having one hell of a good time.
Hey, there's a town a couple hundred miles east of here. I'm gonna head for it. All right? I left you some grub. I'll be back in about a week.
Pisung naran no?
What?
Pisung naran no?
No, it's too far. You stay, okay? You stay here. I'll send a plane to get you. All right? I'll be back in a little bit.
You as sure as a bullet in the head. We just run this little drill to make Saul feel better. Because next time, who knows, it could be my ass, or Shepard's, or yours.
He would have done the same for us.
What?
He would have done the same for us.
You're goddamn right he would. But that don't change the facts.
see, the way I figured is I'd probably walk for 5 days. Maybe, I don't know, 15, 20 miles a day. So that would put us probably 80, 90 miles from the plane. So if Shep is flying a triangular grid from Queen Maud Gulf, Bathurst, Yellowknife, and that was them, and they're flying east, they'd see the plane. I mean, and they'd see the SOS, and then they'd know we're alive. But no, you know, we're here in the middle of bloody nowhere because I left the plane. Shit! You never, never, never leave the plane! You know, I know it was them. We gotta go back.
You know, you're gonna cut my circulation off there.
Ayumi Tuma. Imare.
Sheesh. Alright.
I'm
a bloody invalid, I'm good. I got it, I'm good.
Pilio.
Alright, let's go back to camp.
Aka, imare.
No, I'm not going in the water.
Ayumi
no.
I'm
gonna get
okay.
Soaked.
It's okay.
Oh.
Pilio. Imarciti.
Huh. How about that? Watertight. I got boots. Married. I used to have a girl. That was a while ago.
How old?
32.
32, no wife.
Well, how old are you?
Avati.
Avati, 20? How about you? You got a wife? Taima. You know, you've been singing the same song for 3 days now. I mean, have mercy, woman. Man can only take so much of this. Do you know any other songs? Do you, you know anything with like a tune or a beat?
You sing.
Nah, that's not what I meant.
You sing now.
All right. Fine, I'll sing. When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore.
When the world seems to shine like you've had too much wine, that's amore.
Bells ring, ting-a-ling-a-ling, ting-a-ling-a-ling, angels sing of me, Isabella. Excuse me, but you see, back in old Napoli, that's amore. That's amore.
So?
Sit down. Search and rescue called. They've been at it for almost 3 weeks now. And you know what they say about them? They have a perfect record. They've never found anybody. The country is just so big, you know. And if, God forbid, the plane burned, they could fly right over the top of it and never see anything at all.
Still, let's go.
I'm sorry, kid.
You okay? Here, sit down. Just rest a while. What the hell's that? It's not the plane. You see that? God. Sweet Jesus, look at this.
You know, I think this is a Beach 18. Sure took a tumble. Look at all this stuff. Come look at this. Come here. Use some of this. Look up in here. All kinds of stuff. Yeah. Use that. Uh-huh. Look at the jackpot here. Kill a few squirrels with that, huh? Come on, there's all kinds of it. Give me a hand. It's okay. It's okay. Poor son of a bitch. Too bad. Use it for something. Come on. Come on, give me a hand. Oh, yeah. Jackpot. Look at that. Thank you. Oh, that's gonna save us right there. We were meant to find this stuff, Canala. Would you at least look at me? I'm talking.
talking to you. Would you look at me?
What are you doing? He doesn't need these things, you know.
Noon ako Java, anong nakaw? World has many spirits. All things. Anong na?
Breath. Everything breathes.
Some spirits good. Ikayok to eh. Some bad. They trick you. Vangaro. When you die, Takit will come.
Who's that? Who's Takit? Is he a spirit?
He. Tautusu.
He sees you? He watches you.
He says, Malilere, come. It's okay. It's your time now. It's okay.
Where does he take you when he comes?
I'm gonna sing that jacklone. Good hunting. Many seals. Fish. Ivy.
Walrus?
Ivy.
Sounds like a good place.
When you die, you need Bikuti.
I need your tools. I see. So, where does Takit live?
Takpika Takit.
Hmm?
Tao tukto. Takra.
Hey.
Oh. I was just trying to figure out whose dog that is. You off work?
No, just a break. I told Jimmy I needed some air. I wanted to tell you something. I know you feel bad, Shep, but this wasn't your fault. You weren't responsible for him. Nobody was. And when it comes right down to it, all of us are just alone in this world, and that's just the way it is. Oh, I brought you something. I thought you might like to have it. Okay.
What are you doing?
Getting my stuff. I heard they called off the search.
Yeah.
That's a tough break. Listen, if you're looking for another flyer, I got a buddy of mine you might want to meet. He and I are partners in a couple of side deals we got going. I do a little speculating now and again myself, you know. Matter of fact, you know, we should talk. Because, you know, maybe we could work out a little arrangement.
Get out.
What?
You heard me. Go on, get the hell out of here. Before I throw you through the goddamn wall.
Nothing. Not a note, not a sign, nothing. How could they miss this? How could they not see us? You know, the snow's coming. What's it gonna get, 20, 40 below? How are we gonna eat then, huh? How are we gonna stay alive? I don't even know why you came for me. Well, you know what the real joke is? We never had a chance. We were dead the minute we hit the ground. Ah! Ah!
نغم اختارم یک شخصی رو نغم اون این نغمی
Leave me alone.
Leave me alone.
I said leave me alone.
Tuk-tuk nani pat.
What?
Took to a girtur. Tove.
Thank you.
What is that?
Geeks out.
It's like fat.
Geeks out.
I don't know. Yeah, you eat this?
Mama Rilara.
Pretty good.
What do you do? Una usto kago.
Oh. I was just thinking about this steakhouse in Montreal called Moishe's. I used to always go there with the fellas from my outfit. And I'm telling you, no word of a lie, these steaks in this joint were at least 5 inches thick. They had it all, boy. They had, you know, top sirloin, New York, ribeye. And you walk in there and you could smell it wafting through the joint, sizzling on the grill, and they'd come to the table with these giant spuds, you know, just swimming in butter and sour cream and chives and fried onions and mushrooms. And the wine just flowing like bloody spring water. Of course, you know, the fellas would get a little tight, start getting lit up on the sauce and start, you know, jaw wagging about all the crazy dumbass shit we did during the war. Those were good times. Funny thing, you know, what war does to some people. You know, you think you know a fella and seems perfectly normal, then one day just the hammer drops and snaps, you know, just falls all to pieces. Just because of what we saw over there, you know, what we saw during the war. You never, in your wildest dreams, thought you'd see stuff like that. And you never thought you could do the things you did. And things you just grow to hate yourself for. But somehow you make your peace with it. At least you try.
Soon we walk.
Mm.
canola pea.
Canoing.
Here. Put this around you.
Canoing it.
Oh, damn. Aka, aka. That's enough for today. Okay, Harley. Oh, shit, you burned up. Namatu. Namatu. It's okay. It's okay. You just pushed yourself too hard today. It's okay. Namatu. It's okay. It's okay. Namatu. Namatu.
How you doing, right?
I'm okay.
Good.
There was a small girl. Ilagi.
Family. Family hunting. She was hunting with her family.
Father. Ukuluni anaktaruluni.
Father was hurt. Couldn't hunt. The storm, snow.
Many days, nothing to. Ata tanga, takil mo piyaw yu. Took father, mother. Iglumi aniluni pisusiyo.
She went away to die because there was no food? More food for children?
Sister was dying. So the girl. Darin kilirlunigi nukani qimiriya.
You fed her with your blood. Then what happened?
People came.
But Tuckett never came.
Tricked him. Yo-yo.
Yo-yo.
Yeah, I figure we just keep heading north and we're bound to run into a hunting party or a village sooner or later. And I can radio for a medevac, get you straight into a hospital. I'll take care of you in a hospital. I got good medicine since the war. I tell you another thing, we're not going to Yellowknife neither. Take you to the big city, like Edmonton. You been to the city? Oh, you wouldn't believe your eyes. There's cars and people everywhere, all over the streets. Millions of kabloonas everywhere.
Moishis?
Huh?
Moishis.
Oh, no, that's in Montreal. But you know, same thing in Edmonton. Listen, I'll tell you what. As soon as you get out of the hospital, I'll take you for a big steak dinner. All right? All the mushrooms, potatoes, and onions.
I didn't know Charlie Halliday for very long. But I do know he was a good pilot and a good friend. We are gathered here today because he was taken from us much too soon. Words are cold comfort when a young life is cut so short. But I thought I might read from a poem I found, written by a young Canadian flight lieutenant named John McGee during the war, and found in his locker after he was shot down. Oh, I have slipped the surly bonds of earth and danced the skies on laughter-silvered wings. Sunward I've climbed and joined the tumbling mirth of sun-split clouds and done 100 things you have not dreamed of. Wheeled and soared and swung high in the sunlit silence. Hovering there, I've chased the shouting wind along and flung my eager craft through footless halls of air, up, up the long, delirious, burning blue. I've topped the windswept heights with easy grace, where never lark or even eagle flew. And while with silent, lifting mind, I've trod the high, untrespassed sanctity of space, put out my hand and touched the face of God.
Good night.